In this video, I'm going to integrate e to the negative x squared from negative infinity to infinity. E to the negative x squared does not have an antiderivative that we can write down in terms of elementary functions. So I can't antidifferentiate this and write down something like e to the negative x squared times 1 over x squared or something like that. It doesn't work. So anytime that we are trying to work with an integral expression involving this function, we have to use some kind of technique. I really enjoy this computation because in order to compute this single integral, we are going to pass to a double integral. So I just think it's really neat and a little bit unexpected. All right, let me show you how to do this. So there are a lot of steps here that I think are fun. The first thing I'm going to do is recognize the even symmetry of the integrand and write that this improper integral from negative infinity to infinity can be thought of as twice the integral from 0 to infinity of e to the negative x squared dx. Okay, I just like having a fixed lower bound rather than two infinite bounds. The next thing I'm going to do is square both sides. So let's square the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, you might expect me to just write the same thing, parentheses with a square, but that's not what I'm going to do. I'm going to write it's this quantity times a version of itself. So this times 2 times the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative, I could write negative x squared dx. However, this is not an indefinite integral. So the final answer is going to be a number. It doesn't matter if I call the variable that we're integrating with respect to x or u, or as I'm about to write down, y. Okay, so we now have 2 times 2 times the product of two single integrals, one with respect to x and the other with respect to y. Often in multivariable calculus, we might have a double integral where we recognize that the integrand can be factored into a function of x times a function of y, the bounds are all constant, and we take that double integral and separate it into the product of two single integrals. Here we're going to go the other direction. So I'm going to take these two single integrals and put them together into a double integral. Let me do that, and I will stick with the infinite bounds for now, and then we will switch into like how to set it up as a proper improper integral, as you will, so how to really do this correctly. All right, so 2 times 2 is 4. And then sticking with the infinite bounds, I'm going to write this as 4 times 0 to infinity, 0 to infinity, e to the negative x squared times e to the negative y squared. But since that's a product of exponentials, e to the negative x squared times e to the negative y squared is really just e to the negative x squared minus y squared dx dy. All right, pause for a moment and catch up if you're thinking about a step that I was going over. Then I want you to look at this domain of integration and identify it. So give it a name and start thinking about how we might, say, switch into polar coordinates, because that's what we're about to do. We see this negative x squared minus y squared, so we think, hey, that looks like, you know, an x squared plus y squared, that's r squared when we switch into polar coordinates. How might you want to model this domain with polar coordinates? Both x and y go from 0 to infinity, so that places us in the first quadrant in the xy plane. That's that name I was looking for, so first quadrant. All right, so here's the domain of integration. We want to describe this now with polar coordinates, which means that we need a radius and an angle. We can read right off the graph that the angle should go from 0 to pi over 2. For the radius, if we imagine this like a quarter disk, I'm going to do this in, how about blue? I don't use blue very often. Okay, I hope you can see this against the pink. But imagine this quarter disk has radius capital B. If we let B grow to infinity, then that's going to fill in the first quadrant for us. So let's now switch into polar coordinates where the angle will go from 0 to pi over 2, and then the radial coordinate will go from 0 to capital B, and we will let B go to infinity. That's actually also going to take into account how we should be setting up this improper integral. So typically you wouldn't say 0 to infinity, you would say 0 to t and then let t go to infinity. We're now going to bring that notation into our computation. So leaving the 4 out front, we'll have 4 times the limit as capital B grows to infinity of a double integral where, let me write 0 to B on the outside, 0 to pi over 2 on the inside. So we'll take care of the angle first. E to the negative x squared minus y squared is e to the negative r squared. And then in the conversion to polar, we pick up r, then d theta, dr. This double integral you can probably handle right now. If you'd like to, you could pause and work through it. Oh, this marker's not very good. Okay, so let's see if this one's better. A little bit better. Okay, so we'll have 4 limit as b grows to infinity. Let's go ahead and do the anti-differentiation with respect to theta. There is no theta term here, so it's like, imagine this times the number 1, anti-differentiate 1 to theta, plug in pi over 2 minus 0. All that to say is that we'll have pi over 2 minus 0. This expression comes out of the anti-differentiation with respect to theta, and then we still have dr. The pi over 2 we'll pull out front, that's just a number. For this, we can pass into polar coordinates u substitution if it makes it easier to see how to anti-differentiate this. Let u be negative r squared so that du is negative 2r dr. We see the r dr right here. So I'm going to bring the pi over 2 all the way out front and write 2 pi times the limit as b goes to infinity. We will change our bounds as part of the substitution. When r is 0, u is negative 0 squared. That's a 0. And then when r is capital B, u is negative b squared. The pi over 2 came out front. E to the negative r squared is u. Oh, sorry, e to the u. And then r dr is negative 1 over 2 du. Okay, I think we can finish this all on the next line because at this point, it's not too bad. Let's pull the negative 1 half out front to write negative pi times the limit as b goes to infinity. We can anti-differentiate e to the u. It is just e to the u. So let's go ahead and plug in our bounds. E to the negative b squared minus e to the 0. Pause if you need to and make sure I didn't go too fast here. So work through this computation if you need, and then we will come back and just finish the final answer. All right, to finish this computation, we just have to recognize that as b goes to infinity, negative b squared goes to negative infinity, which means this first exponential expression is like exponential decay down to 0. And then for the second term, e to the 0 is 1. So that overall, this expression is negative 1. So the limit as b goes to infinity of this is negative 1 times negative pi gives us pi, which means going back to our original computation, the integral from negative infinity to infinity of e to the negative x squared dx is the square root of pi. All right, I hope you enjoyed working through this computation. Thank you for your attention.